Look at the titties on her.
Hey, darling, you looking for a good time?
Danny, keep it down. No, actually, did you get a look at the titties? I mean, God damn.
Damn it, shut your mouth before you get us arrested.
Stop, God damn it, stop! Fuck you, pig!
Hey, man. Get off the phone. Right fucking now.
I will not be treated in such a manner.
Y'all keep an eye out. We're some deep shit and need your help.
Where are you?
Just off the parade route. Danny's hurt.
I can't get a car to you because the roads are closed off. Grocery store on the backside of the cemetery. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
There'll be a car waiting at the loading dock. And Lincoln, be careful, yeah? You and Ellie Sport.
Open your eyes,
will.
Why don't you?
Sammy's having a car delivered. It'll be at the loading dock at the grocery store.
God bless the old man. Let's go.
Tell me what you did with the purse.
I already done told you. I didn't take shit from that bitch.
Boat used in the robbery was found abandoned beneath the French Ward. All units respond. Suspects are a Negro male, approximately 6'4", a white male, approximately 5'11", and two unknown accomplices. They are armed and extremely dangerous.
Fuck, they found the boat!
Stay cool, man. We're still good.
That's not what she's saying.
There's something wrong with that boy.
Lucky I don't leave your drunk ass in a ditch.
I'm sorry.
Do not fucking move.
Oh, shit.
What the fuck are we gonna do?
Ellis.
Fucking pigs are everywhere.
Ellis. Chill out. Everything's gonna be fine. All right, you guys take Danny and the money. Get to the car. I'll deal with the cops. I'll warn them off you.
Hey, no fucking way, man.
It's all right. He ain't going alone. We all got a friend, Jesus.
Amen.
All right, let's go.
Hey! Over here!
People can't
do it. 3-5. Suspicious person on foot. Responding unit investigating.
Shit! Shoot the good one!
Don't you stand there!
Run!
After the cocksucker that this week's been a little hungry.
No,
there, fucking oh.
She's going down. Give me back up.
Run, go, go.
Just let me be, please.
Well, shit, get off the.
Daddy, someone always tries to convince me how great it is to live in Southern California.
Negative visual on suspect. Begin search in immediate vicinity. All units, negative visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact lost.
Men have expectations, needs. If you can't fill it, well, they'll find someone else who can. And?
God damn!
On scene, officers engaging with suspect. Respond with caution. All units, code 60. Officer injured on scene. Negative visual on suspect. Begin
Where's Georgie?
Search in immediate vicinity.
We got separated. Before we lost sight of him, he said he'd meet us back at the house. Get in!
Code 35. Suspicious person and vehicle. Responding unit investigated. On scene, officers engaging with suspect. Respond with caution.
Thank you.
suspect. Begin search in immediate vicinity.
Oh, we managed to get out of this? I'm sleeping on a bed of titties. I don't care what it fucking costs.
They gone?
Yeah, man, they done.
I knew we could pull it off. I knew it! We're rich! Fuck!
I'm robbing people with a six gun.
I fought the law,
and the law can kiss my ass.
I fought the law, and the law lost.
How much is it?
A little over $2 million. Per split.
Holy mother God.
Once everything's settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over 3 hookers.
Boy, ain't no hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? 'Cause 2 of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new Drifter.
I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. What you boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. Ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us. Huh? Vouloir, c'est pouvoir, eh?
Vouloir, c'est pouvoir!
Well, well, well.
Oh, man,
look
at the man.
Ho! And look at what I dug up. You mind pouring one more of those?
Holy shit.
It'll be my pleasure.
Judgey told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sal. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it?
All right.
Listen, I got a guy outside. Y'all mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look at that.
Let's see if you can handle this down-home hooch.
Yeah, why don't you give me some of that?
Trying to get some corn whiskey? Make you a man.
They all the same.
Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut. Plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us something off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Yeah. You ain't got to tell me, twice.
Hey, fill me up. All right.
Know something, Lincoln? You're possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on. You shouldn't have said no. Where the fuck you think you're going?
Stupid fucking niggas.
Come on, grab that bag. Let's go.
When I got to Sammy's, the whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Luck? Divine providence? Or something else? Out of the fire, he woke up long enough to tell me to call John Donovan. So that's what I did. Most days I wish I'd never made that call.
Mr. Donovan, do you know this individual?
Sure. Sal Marcano.
Mm-hmm. And how about this man?
That's Sal's worthless piece of shit brother, Lou. Look, enough of the dog and pony bullshit. What's your real question?
Did you help Lincoln Clay murder Sal Marcano and all prominent members of his crime family?
You're goddamn right I did.
I see the bad moon rising. I see trouble on the way. I see earthquakes and lightning. I see bad times today. Don't go around tonight. Let's finally take your life. There's a bad moon on the right. I hear hurricanes are blowing. I know the end is coming soon. I feel rivers overflowing. I hear the voice of rage and ruin.
So those the men you're gonna kill, huh?
That's the plan, Padre.
It's a dangerous course you're contemplating.
And what do you think we should do?
Sal Marcano deserves to die. I won't argue otherwise. Kill him. But let that be the end of it.
That's not enough!
It's enough if you say it's enough. I know what Sal did to you, Lincoln. But nothing you do will bring any of them back.
This isn't about bringing them back. Or even exacting some street justice. It's about making that bastard feel what it's like to lose everything. Watch as I take it all away from him.
This is a one-way road, Lincoln. And once you start down it, there ain't no turning back.
I'm going to Sammy's to get my stuff. You ready?
I'll be waiting in the car.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek. Now fight back. Problem is, that don't work. Not in the real world.
When raindrops fall and you feel low, I'll do you everything. It's useless. Do you feel like letting go? Will the world ever change? And just how long?
Ready to roll when you are.
To have it all rearranged. Tell me why these things are.
The Padre doesn't seem too keen on the plan.
You don't need to worry about him.
I'd just hate to encounter any of that Catholic guilt I'm always hearing about.
He knows every low-life thing I've ever done and has never ratted me out. If I say we can trust him, we can trust him.
Fair enough. So you mind telling me what we're really doing?
We're gonna kill Marcano and all the assholes who work for him.
Bullshit. If that's all you're after, you'd grab an XM-21, smear on some face paint, and they'd all be dead before dinner. And you sure as hell wouldn't need a TACOP center and all this other shit you've asked me for.
After I got back, Marcano offered me the Harlem, said it was time for Sammy to retire. I told him no.
So you think what happened is your fault?
Hard to see it otherwise.
What do you think Sal was going to do? Host a little party for Sammy? Maybe give him a gold watch and a plaque congratulating him on his retirement? We both know there's only one way out of the life. And you still haven't answered my question.
I'm going to take over the city, district by district.
McConnell wanted me to run the Hollow? Fuck him. By the time I'm done, I'll be running the whole goddamn city.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Assuming, of course, you're up for something that strenuous.
How the fuck wouldn't I be?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe because you got shot in the face?
I might have lost a step or two, but it'll come back to me. Always does.
God, if that isn't the fucking truth. One other thing. Probably not much of a surprise, but most of the cops in this town are in Sal's pocket.
Yeah, kind of always assumed that.
Just being diligent. The cops see you fighting Sal's goons. They're coming after you, every time. Damn it, Lincoln. Where are you going? Sure you don't need a ride?
Nah, man, I'm good.
I'll be at the motel. Come see me when you're ready.
Is dying over there in Vietnam.
There's something I gotta do.
I ever tell you how I got this?
Sure, you stole it.
That I did. I had the pocket of this old white man just to come around here raising him. Take this with you. It's always brought me good luck.
I can't do that.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln. No, but you're not. You never will be.
Thank you.
the newest and coolest in home entertainment, there's only one place to go. Holton's Department Store.
Holton's Department Store has more of what you're shopping for.
Welcome, welcome, dear listener, to another episode of Native Son. I'm your host, Remy Duvall. How y'all doing out there? Because I'm doing...
Get some units over here!
There's been a call about a hit and run in the hollow. If any of y'all got the patience for it, feel free to swing by.
You weren't lying about setting up a tax center.
Key to running a successful black bag operation is plausible deniability. This is why I stole all this shit from the FBI. Things go tits up, those chicken dicks can deal with the fallout.
Glad to see you haven't lost your touch.
If there's one thing I'm good at, it's fucking with Hoover's Ferry Brigade. And while you were convalescing, I did some digging around. Wanted to see if there are any local assets for you to recruit. I came up with three possibilities.
Right now, my priority is getting the hollow out from whoever ended up with it.
Figured as much.
Haitians? Well, I thought they fell apart after I put Baca down.
Lucky for us, they're back up. And they're none too pleased that Sal gave Delray Hollow to the Dixie Mafia.
Dixie Mafia?
Georgie's idea. He's got him running heroin, trying to get everybody hooked.
Motherfucker. Now, I'll be damned if I let those coon asses destroy everything that Sammy built up. Who replaced Baca?
Unknown. Managed to keep his identity a secret.
Unknown? Even to John Donovan? Never thought I'd see the day.
Well, I can't help it if I was born pigmentally challenged.
So, you telling me my only option is to tail one of these Haitians? Hope he leads me back to the mysterious leader?
Hey, it's better than no options. And once you've ingratiated yourself with them, you come see me. I'm finishing something up you're gonna want to see.
Guests need to bring us their appetites. So you're hearing this, and you know a vet who just got back from active service, you tell him to come on down to the Yacht Club in Frisco Field Saturday night at 7 p.m. Because we are going to treat them right.
They're flying James L. Ray back this week. Still amazes me they expect us to believe it was one man who did end up the king.
I am pleased to see you.
Too bad.
Let's say he was the one who shot Dr. King. Just him and no one else. What if it's really that easy to strike down a great man like Dr. King, President Kennedy, Brother Malcolm?
Then nothing in this country will ever change.
Yeah, you struggle, and you sweat, and someone can take it all away just like that.
Hey there, brown sugar. You sure looking sweet today.
Cocksuckers run this shit like clockwork.
What was that?
Where'd he come from?
We all want Dixie out of the hollow. Give me your boss and I'll make it happen.
Fuck. Shit. Get to the voodoo shop. You'll find the boss there.
Sorry about the headache, brother.
you doing?
Coffee?
Nice trick you pulled back at the Haitian camp, pretending Baca was holding you prisoner.
And I held you while dead. It appears we both full of surprises.
Certainly does.
What can I do for you, Lincoln Clay?
I want you to help me kill Sal Marcano.
I see. A few months ago, you was trying to kill me. Now you break in here and expect me to trust you?
Now that Marcano's backing the Dixie Mafia, it's only a matter of time till they come for you. And when they do, they'll kill everyone standing in their way.
Lest I hitch my horse to your wagon, so to speak.
I'll see to it that you get the hollow. After that, depends on how things shake out.
Do you know why Sammy and I were at war?
On account of you going after the lottery?
Please. Just because you don't want to face some uncomfortable truths ain't a reason to act naive. Sammy and I were fighting because the people in Dahala deserve better than a two-faced old man who handed out cans of food whenever the mood hit him. Who always did what Sal Marcano told him to do, even if it pitted him against his own people.
He did the best he could.
And yet his best didn't amount to much, did it? Once I have the holler, I run it as I see fit. No questions asked.
Long as you give me access to your muscle, your connections, and a place to hold up from time to time, you can do what you want.
Marcona replaced Sammy with a man named Richie Doucette. Do you know of him?
Assume he's Dixie Mafia.
He's a Wooster! Likes to kidnap black teenagers and take them out to the bayou. After starving them for a few days, he cuts them loose, tells them to run. Sometimes he brings out the dogs, you know, for old time's sake. That's how he killed my sister. This is all I have left.
How do I find him?
It's still dangerous around here for him, so he stays on the move. But his men operate out of the community church in the old theater, Pearl as it used to be called.
It was named after Sammy's wife. I'm taking it down first.
One of my men have been staking it out. Seeing what he can learn about how it's being run. You should talk to him and see what he knows.
Once I deal with it, I'll see about the church.
Ooh, Lord, it's hot in the holler. Damn hot. But I'm not talking about the temperature, neither. But it's that, too. This is the Holler Speaks, and tonight we're talking about the Hollow's own, Sammy Robinson. Not just a leader, but a source of inspiration within our community. Along with his son, Ellis, and his adopted boy, Lincoln Clay. He did everything he could to support our community through his benevolent society. If someone couldn't quite make the bill,
he just met him and died.
Couldn't put food on the table. Sammy was there to lend a hand. But he was taken from us far too soon in that tragic bar fire. The boys along with him. Bar fire. Can you believe that's still the official ruling on what happened? We know the truth. Been over it more times than I care to count. As a community, the Holler's still trying to fight back from that loss. And to make matters worse, we got new folk.
Lincoln, you a sight for sore eyes.
Laveau, been a while. Wasn't expecting to see you working with the Haitians.
It's either this or bow down to them fucking coon asses, and you know I ain't ever been one to bow down to anyone.
Ain't that the goddamn truth?
Cassandra phoned ahead. Say you going out to Perla's. Asshole named Merle Jackson runs it. Turned it into a brothel. That's white fellas come in and do whatever they want to our young sisters.
How do I get to them?
You don't. Not yet, anyway. A lot of those Dixie fucks try to stay out of sight. There's someone put a bullet up their ass.
If I hit his operations, he'll have to come out and deal with me.
I got an idea how to get his attention. He got some girls locked up on the second floor of Perla's. Calls them his thoroughbreds. Has them strung out on all kind of shit. He makes a lot of money off them. Go in there quiet. Get them out of there.
I'll let you know when it's done.
Hey, I'm sorry to hear about Sammy and Ellis. They always did right by me.
Mr. Laveau told me you'd be coming. The girls are upstairs. Be careful. Merle's people are all over the place.
I will. Thanks.
Oh, excuse me.
Huh?
But how, motherfucker? You gonna...
Yes.
Get him out of the way!
You piece of shit!
Ducking down!
Yeah, burn, boy! Oh, shit! Get out of here!
We have to go. We have to get out of here.
I won't get the valley of the shadow of death.
Get out of here.
Run that motherfucker out of here.
Once you're out of here, go see Cassandra at the Pierced Heart. She'll help you.
Simple, simple. I used to be a terminator, never mind. What I say, it's
all you. Spread the word. Any woman needing help should go to the Pierced Heart.
Thank you.
Oh, fuck. Shit. I ain't ready to die. Well,
I what? I think he's on.
Oh.
Fuck.
Surprise.
Brother, calm down. You have to use a lighter touch, is all.
What am I supposed to do? Fucking animal acts like I'm.
Run that motherfucker out of here. I'll be dipped in.
Something.
Can't hide from me, boy.
You piece of shit! Gotcha,
I got a little something for you. You've been running around so much out there, I figured I'd make your life a little easier. You can use this to call on your support.
And here I was thinking you were a heartless asshole.
Jury's still out on that one.